is het wel.
Ja, en bij onderhoud krijg je nu verderop voor maar 25 euro per jaar. Bankgarage. Altijd.
Is daar heel dichtbij?
Terwijl jij nog slaapt, rookt het onze bakker de lekkerste ontbijt aan. Ook Granola zorgt voor grote moeite en met heel weinig suikers. En we bezorgen hem kraakvers bij je thuis. Hoor maar, de beste granola koop je niet in de winkel. Die bestel je op oat.nl.
Vandaag de dag vraagt de energie van vandaag. Daarom steken wij elke dag een handen uit de bak. Met 100 jaar ervaring, deskundig en vol.
America's worst prison. 15 juni op 10 uur op Crime Investigation.
The Red Sea is an ancient trade route, and that's where I'm heading next. To dive on some of the most spectacular shipwrecks in the world.
Ross Kemp, Deep Sea Treasure Hunter. Elke vrijdag om 8:30 op History Channel.
That look just like flying craft. And when I went to Japan, I had the honor to see two ancient stone carvings that are believed to represent flying ships witnessed by the people who lived there thousands of years ago.
Honshu, Japan, April 2017. Near the modern-day city of Osaka, Giorgio Sicalo meets with fellow ancient astronaut theorist Takeharu Mikami to investigate one of the oldest and holiest sites in the country. The Ishinohoden Megalith is a giant stone monument carved out of the bedrock on the mountainside and is believed by some researchers to date back an astonishing 16,000 years.
Wow, it's gigantic. I have no idea. It is massive.
The rock itself is said to weigh about 500
tons. 500
tons?
Wow. Okay. That's amazing. I need to walk around. Very weird. I have no idea how massive this is.
So we'll look for a stone building.
You want to just look down below here?
What are you doing?
It looks like it's floating over the water.
It really does.
The name for this rock is Amano-Nishi, or the floating rock from the heavens.
So, basically, この岩を作った神様ですね。
So this monolith is said to be related to one of the first gods that descended from the heavens in Japan, and he is said to have over the country on a skyship made out of a giant rock, which was called Amano Iwakune, which is the heavenly rock ship.
So what you're telling me is that there is an ancient Japanese legend that speaks of a deity flying around in the sky with a gigantic vehicle made of stone.
Absolutely.
So do you think that is the reason why the vehicle made of stone? Because it was so powerful and strong and virtually slowly became its umbilical made of stone.
Sora kara mutte chijou no
omida. You're absolutely right, because the gods were flying over the land on a giant ship. It wasn't a plane, it didn't have wings. It looked like a ship made out of very hard material that was like a very hard stone, and they descended from the heavens down to the land, and thus they would travel around the country.
Absolutely impressive. To me, the issue of holding megalith was an attempt by our ancestors to document an extraterrestrial visitation, and they chose this incredibly hard stone as a way to represent the color and indestructible nature of the craft they saw in the sky. And if this wasn't proof enough of alien contact, during my trip to Japan, I investigated another ancient site with an almost identical legend.
Asuka Park, Japan, April 2017.
That's a rock ship.
Giorgio Sikalos, an ancient astronaut theorist, Takiharu Mikami, set out to examine Masuda no Iwafune, an 800-ton rock structure that was carved from a single piece of granite and resembles no other architecture in Japan.
Check out this square grid on the sides. I mean, this is something that I've seen before in India, in Mahabalipuram, where they have the same mythology of celestial beings, and they had something very similar on the side of some of their rocks as well.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait to see the top. Amazing. Oh. Wow, that is, I mean, I've never seen anything like it.
While some researchers believe the Masuda no Iwafune megalith is a tomb, others claim it is meant to depict the sky boats that are described in ancient Japanese stories.
So the idea is that this was the entrance to a Buddhist temple. What do they mean by that? Inside, I mean, where?
It would actually predate Buddhism in Japan, so it would have anything to do with Buddhist temples.
Right. So what is the actual translation of Masuda no Iwafune?
Masuda is the name of a region, and Iwafune literally means stone ship or rock ship.
Okay.
Yes, it's naturally the Iwafune or the rock ship would have come down from heavens as a vehicle for the gods to descend upon earth.
So I guess with the combination of the mythologies of celestial beings, this could be some type of representation of one of those flying vehicles that our ancestors perhaps witnessed.
Could the giant stone monuments, both in Asuka Park and in Honshu, have been inspired by encounters with extraterrestrial craft descending from the sky? Ancient astronaut theorists say yes, and they believe that further proof of otherworldly contact in the distant past can be found halfway around the world, at a mysterious megalithic site high in the Andes Mountains. Coming up,
the surface is as smooth as a tabletop. This was a machine. How anyone could think that primitive human beings could have done this? It's just crazy.
Yeah,
anything looks like ancient aliens. It's this stone.
Everybody loves a treasure story.
From the markers from the Curse of Oak Island. The Deal of Vanilla is to open. That name is written Martin in the war book. And also, the floats to be steam is to be able to open Stutter or the Zucca.
Every turn around is a
possible reward. Stolen house, the report of the death, for fruit is Stutter.
You are searching the truth and searching the answers.
The world's greatest treasure mysteries, Elgar Mama of Hall of Nature, new history channel.
Head and shoulders, you couldn't get your house up.
Happy.
Can you help?
Yeah, can you help?
Happy.
You have two rows with new head and shoulders. I must rows with and for mine, that's purple.
More efficient. We see this a lot. People who don't make choice. So we built a time machine that they connect with the 5 minutes from now, future self.
Onze bakker de lekkerste ontbijt gaan. Ook granola, chock van grote noten en met heel weinig suikers. En we bezorgen een kraakvers bij je thuis. Hoor maar, de beste granola koop je niet in de winkel. Die bestel je op moot.nl.
Wij helpen Nederland al 100 jaar vooruit. En ook de zekerheid van een 3-jarig contract en een lage gepaste tarieven. Kijk op sint.nl.
Probeer de populairste granola's van oud. Nu de eerste 4 weken voor maar €15.
Ondersteuning voor soepele spieren en je zenuwstelsel? Probeer nu een vitaal magnesium 400 mg capsules met vitamine B6 en L-tryptofaan. En dus alle Lucovitaal 1+1 gratis en gratis promo-potje magnesium capsules. Wat je vraag ook is, stel het aan onze drogist. Krijg wat steeds verrassend, altijd voordelig.
In deze leerklas, verhalen herschreven.
Restoration. Elke woensdag om 8:30 nu op History Channel.
Many of the incredible structures found around the world were built with stone blocks so massive, it seems impossible that they could have been moved without advanced technology. But for me, the site of Pumapunku in Bolivia is the most astounding of all. Because not only are the stones megalithic, they're carved with a precision that we would have a hard time replicating, even with modern tools.
Bolivia, South America. Here, 45 miles west of La Paz, isolated high in the Andes Mountains, lie the mysterious ancient ruins of Pumapunku. Spread across a desert plateau at an altitude of over 12,000 feet, the megalithic stones found here are among the largest on the planet. some measuring up to 26 feet long and weighing more than 100 tons.
What you have here are massive blocks scattered like some kids' toy blocks around the site. Like some giant cataclysm just wiped out this entire area. Archaeologists are baffled by what Pumapunku was, how it looked, and what the purpose of this enormous structure would have been. One of the amazing things here at Pumapunku is the precision of the blocks. You can see with this block that it's really been cut at very accurate right angles. Not only do these blocks have precision corners, but they also have these difficult drill holes that are going right through the rock.
In January 2011, ancient astronaut theorist David Childress and author Brian Forsker gained unprecedented access to investigate this incredible site.
You know, Brian, this is one of the most interesting and unusual stones here at Pumapunku. It's got these perfect right angles. And each of these small drill holes are basically evenly spaced along this powder groove. To me, it's clear that power tools have been used on this unusual block of stone.
Oh, exactly. This surface is as smooth as a tabletop, like in your kitchen. There's no wave to it or anything. This was machined. But who machined it? It's an astonishing piece of work. And how anyone could think that primitive human beings could have done this, you know, it's just crazy. Anything looks like ancient aliens is this stone.
What did the ancients use to cut these stones so precisely? Might evidence of advanced technology be found by further study of the construction of the Pumapunku stones? Ancient astronaut theorists say yes, and point to what they call H-blocks.
Seems like every one of these H-blocks is exactly the same, so it's like a prefabrication process where they needed X hundred of these, and whatever machinery it is that they had was able with amazing accuracy to replicate one after another after another. It seems as though some kind of factory was set up there to make these almost exactly the same. It's almost like a Lego system of interconnected blocks, and that is unique on this earth. An ingenious way of building a huge wall, and again, the whole thing is just so incredibly precise. Doing these kind of inside corners like this just can't be done really with copper chisels and stone hammers. The whole thing is just so incredibly high tech, even beyond what we would do today. We don't really know the age of Pumapunku. Archaeologists have come up with wildly different ages. Starting with early excavations here, thinking the Pumapunku was up to 20,000 years old. But the kind of machinery that would need to be used to articulate and cut these blocks would be giant diamond saws with huge blades, powerful routers. Even possibly we're talking about plasma cutters and melting of stone. Something that is only being worked on today by modern scientists.
According to the local Aymara people, who have inhabited this region for centuries, Pumapunku was built in a single day, and not by humans, but by the sky gods.
They say the gods constructed the place in one night. This makes sense. Now they've got the group, they come down to Earth. So they construct with their tools just something which we would call the basic paradigm.
When you look at the complexity of Pumapunku, the huge platforms, the interlocking blocks were made into what they thought were indestructible walls. What you could have is the kind of perfectly made spaceport that
ancient city of Pumapunku really have been built by alien beings, as ancient astronaut theorists contend? If so, what happened to these giant, seemingly indestructible structures?
One possibility is that Pumapunku was destroyed in some artificial lab, literally ballooned and building apart.
So much of it is not simply broken, it's shattered. To the point where you can find little tiny pieces of diorite anywhere you look. And that looks to me like an explosion happened. At the end of its use, they may have simply blown it up because they didn't want anyone to use the technology that they had left behind.
Precision stonework, unparalleled engineering, and incomprehensible destruction. Is it possible that Pumapunku was a point of extraterrestrial contact in the distant past? Ancient astronaut theorists say yes, and suggest further evidence of alien engineering can be found on a small island in the Mediterranean that is home to extraordinary stone structures.
One of the most incredible structures that I've ever seen is on the Italian island of Sardinia. This Mediterranean island has thousands of mysterious stone towers, bizarre statues, and even an ancient pyramid. But what was most amazing to me was the Well of Santa Cristina. It features stonework so precise that there is no way it could have been built without advanced engineering knowledge.
Sardinia, May 2018. Oak Island treasure hunter Marty Lagina has invited Giorgio Tsikalos to help